stone in whom the whole building being fitted together is growing into a holy temple in the Lord, in whom you also are being built together into a dwelling of God in the Spirit. May God bless His holy word.
Amen.
Apostle Paul concluded our message of this blessed Sunday with the following words of exhortation, as read also in 1 Corinthians 2:11 to 13. Just as you know how we were exhorting and encouraging and imploring each one of you as a father who his own children, so that you will walk in a manner worthy of the God who calls you into his own kingdom and glory. For this reason, we also constantly thank God that when you received the word of God which you heard from us, you accepted it, not as the word of men, but for what it really is, the word of God, which also performed its work in you who believe. Amen?
Amen.
Can we bow our head to pray, please? Our Lord Jesus, we confess and we proclaim that you are the Lord of our life,
yes,
and that the stripes you bore on the cross at Calvary has established you our Redeemer.
Yes, Lord.
We proclaim that the God Almighty, the Creator of heavens and the earth, is our God and our spiritual Father.
Yes.
This moment we rededicate our lives unto you, Father. We seat ourselves afresh under the jurisdiction of your sovereignty, in that you can have complete rule over our lives. By our faith in Jesus Christ and our belief that you are able, we petition you, Father, to purify our soul from darkness, to deliver us from every stronghold our sins have built against us. We proclaim our desires to make amends to you for every sin we have ever committed, and to rescind every legal right Satan has acquired to control us because of our sins, and we speak forth to make these amends now. In the name of Jesus Christ, we submit every dark and sinful thought and desire we have entertained into your hands, Father, for a work of purification, redemption, and deliverance to take place. We appoint you the highest precedence of authority over every aspect of us, over every sin, over every stronghold, over every emotional war, over every root and what the devil has against us. We proclaim your will shall be done, Father, in how you redeem us, not our will or devil's will. Unite our spirit to your spirit, Father. Strengthen us in your strength. Empower us in your power.
Yes.
Fill our body from the bottom of our toes to the top of our head.
Yes.
With the warm, alive, anointed, atoning, blessed, victorious, sanctified, consecrated blood that Jesus Christ shed for us at Calvary.
Yes.
Wash every part of us in the redeeming blood of Jesus Christ. Spark within us a great Holy Ghost fire. By the authority given us in Luke 10:19, we take authority over every spirit that has set itself up over the sins of our lives, and we command each of these spirits, especially the strong man, bound and rendered powerless, spirit of poverty, spirit of insubordination, spirit of fear, spirit of apostasy by forsaking to walk with you, Lord, and the spirit of selfishness, making us to deny you, Lord, what rightly belongs to you. We command each of these spirits block from drawing or receiving any power from any other spirit or source, and block them from lending any power to any other spirit. Save us, O Lord, from all these sinful acts of these adulterous generations, that at the end we may also be partakers of eternal life. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. May God bless you all.
Oh, Jesus, Amen.
Amen. Amen.
It's now time for altar call. If you would like to receive a prayer, I ask that you please come to the front. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
That if you're sitting there today and you don't have a personal relationship with God, the Bible says today is the day of salvation. Amen. We never want to leave this church. We are offering Christ to you. Amen. Because tomorrow will be too late. And not that we want to show up. We're here today and gone tomorrow. Yes. We don't know. Yes. Don't be afraid, because they went to kill people in the church. Because whatever it is, we are winners. We are conquerors in Jesus. Amen. So today is the, you know, when we absent from the body, we're in the presence of God. So whatever it is for Christian, we win. We win, Christian friend. That's the good news. So if you're sitting there today and you have not accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior,
amen.
Before we go to the altar call, come up and give your life to Christ. We thank God, you know, people sitting here, we know that you have accepted Jesus, so we praise God for that.
Amen.
And so at this time now, we go through our prayers, because prayer is the key.